Hello, it's me again. It's Matt, and I'm here with another mini engine. I know you're gonna think I'm crazy, but I'm gonna try to generate electricity with one of these mini engines, something a lot of people have asked me to do, and I have just the perfect engine for this video. It's a mini engine I got from Engine DIY based off of an old school American pushrod V8. It's one of the most well-made engines that I have ever seen. I just think that with every engine they come out with, they're getting better at making these, and this one is no exception. I hope it runs as good as it looks. We're about to see. But first, I have to put it together. And this is the craziest thing. As I was assembling the V8, I pulled out the block for the V12 and I said, man, look at how much bigger this thing looks. And sure enough, this V8 right here is 28 cc's. This V12 is 50 cc's. Little tiny lifter buckets. This has got to be the coolest feature of this engine, is the starter mounted in between the two heads like that. That's heavy. I saw this little button on the air cleaner and realized they got smart. It's actually the choke. Check that out. I got everything hooked up. The ignition's hooked up. Let me try to start this thing up. I had a little bit of a mix up with the firing order since it wasn't in the manual, but I think I got it right. I think the timing's dead on. Well, as you can see, this thing sounds pretty sweet and it's not even broken in yet. The one thing I noticed, it does seem to be running hot, and that's not only this engine, that's every mini engine I've ran. They all seem to run hot, and I think part of the reason is because the cooling jackets don't have a lot of surface area. In order to make it work at this scale, you need a lot more cooling flow all the time. Well, that thing started right up. Straight, the electric pump, plenty of flow. I'm all done putting together the V8 engine. The only thing left is to break it in, and all this work is making me hungry. I think it's time for factor 75. This is a perfect opportunity for me to use this engine to run an alternator, to power an oven, to heat up my food. Perfect use of a gallon of gasoline. The way this is gonna work is, you could think of this light bulb as the alternator light. As soon as the alternator starts charging the battery, the light goes out and you're gonna see the voltage indicated on the inverter. Let's go. 45 grams of protein. I am super, super hungry right now. I love pasta and I love cheese. Oh my God, it actually smells so good. I'm really hungry. I wanted to shoot this straight away because I don't want to smell this too many times. I'm salivating right now. I know I'm an animal, but I gotta get these in the oven because I'm so hungry. I love to eat. That worked, but not for long because the pulley started melting from the sheer power and friction that this engine is producing. I had to resort to finishing up the cook the conventional way with good old fossil fuel power. It looks amazing. Mine came out a little bit dry. I should have covered it with aluminum foil. Apparently it's juicy because it's all over my pants. No matter what, I just can't stay clean during filming of any of these projects. It's time to eat now. Oh my God, it smells so good. I'm just gonna cut it so you can see how it looks. Oh man, it's nice and tender. I'm telling you, I'm like salivating over here. Look at that. Now, I wish that was for me. That's 45 grams of protein right there. Delicious, but this is not mine, this is my assistant's. I just mixed this up. I'm telling you, man, it smells so good. I wish you could smell this through the camera. Mm-hmm. I need to take some of your pork chop. Man, I'm not even exaggerating. It's so good. Even the veggies are fire. This is really delicious. I'm not even joking, I'm for real. It's really good. You wanna try some of mine? Whew, man. Whew. Those were so good. I ate them all. Factor is probably my absolute favorite meal prep service. And to help you try it for the first time, I got a discount code for you. Head to factor75.com or click the link below and use code 50WARPED to get 50% off plus free shipping on your first Factor box. Let's get back to this challenge. Back to work here. I removed the melted pulley from the engine and printed two new pulleys out of a more heat-resistant material. Move the alternator and the engine up more so everything's in line, nice and neat. Mounted the alternator to the table, and now it's time to try this again. Oh, look at the lights dimming right away now. Wow, it was already overheating that fast. Forgot to turn the cooling pump on. Oh, that was too much load. Stopped it right away. All right, here we go, one last try. Whether or not you could generate electricity with one of these engines, I guess the answer is yes, but not much. the pulley. Sheer power of this engine. Broke that pulley right in half. Did you see that? It's heating up that pulley. I can tell you this much, it sounds broken in now. I think it's ready for the V8 versus V12 challenge. I can't believe it. It almost had enough power to run the alternator. I feel like if the pulley was just a little bit smaller, it would have held on long enough. I'm a little disappointed. I think it would have actually been able to do it if it had a slightly smaller pulley or maybe a smaller alternator. This one's about 500 watts. It's 45 amps at 12 volts. Maybe we'll get about 100 to 200 watts out of the engine reliably. 500 watts, that's under 1 horsepower. The Mini V12 put out 1.25 horsepower in the dyno video. I am still in disbelief that this actually worked. Whether this is a viable option for generating power, I can't see somebody showing up to a campsite with this mounted to a board and running it as a source of power, especially when you actually need power. Even though this engine is cheaper than the others, this one's about $1,000, I still don't see this being a feasible option to generate power. For less than $1,000, you can get an actual generator, but as a gimmick, I can totally see somebody showing up to a campsite with this stuff mounted to a board and running it. I am still in disbelief that this actually worked. Let me know what you think in the comments below. I'm curious to hear what you have to say. Other than that, hopefully you enjoyed this video. I'll see you in the next one.